Hello and welcome to Skyvia Tutorials. In today's video, we will check how to integrate Salesforce and MySQL with no coding. We have selected three scenarios for this tutorial. The first one is data replication from Salesforce to MySQL. Then we will show data sync from MySQL to Salesforce. The final scenario is direct real-time integration of MySQL data with Salesforce via Salesforce Connect with the help of OData endpoints. This tutorial assumes you already have a Skyvia account. If you don't have it, you can create it for free by following the link in the description. Before you start building integrations, you need to create connections to the integrated data sources. Skyvia supports most popular CRMs, including Salesforce, Dynamics 365, Zoho CRM, HubSpot, and others. It supports other cloud apps, databases like MySQL, data warehouses, etc. To create a connection to Salesforce, in the new menu, select Connection, then select Salesforce. Then sign in with your credentials, name, and save connection. There are two ways of creating a connection to MySQL, direct and for the agent. Use direct connection if your MySQL server is accessible through the internet. To create a direct connection, click New, select Connection, and look for MySQL. Let's specify the connection parameters, server address and port, user ID and password, and the database to connect to. If you are going to load UTF-8 data to or from MySQL, also select the Unicode checkbox in the Advanced Connection Parameters. Let's name and save the connection. If your MySQL is located on your local computer or network, use Agent Connection. In this case, Skyvia will connect to the database server via agent application that acts as a secure tunnel between Skyvia and your database server. To connect via agent, let's create an agent. Then download the agent app and install it on your computer. After this, copy or download the agent key. You can paste it in the agent's UI or place the file to in the same folder with the agent app. It's also recommended to name your agent, so you'll be able to locate it easily in future. Once you've downloaded and installed the agent app, create a new connection. Click New, select Connection, and look for MySQL. Select the agent connection mode at the top. Select your agent from the drop-down list and enter the connection parameters. Server's IP address and port, your user ID, password, and select the database to connect to. While using the connection through Agent, make sure that the Agent app is launched. If nothing happens when you launch it, right-click it and select Run as Administrator. If you are going to load UTF-8 data to or from MySQL, also select the Unicode checkbox in the Advanced Connection Parameters. Let's name and save the connection. Now, when connections to Salesforce and MySQL are created, we can move to the examples. Let's start with the replication from Salesforce to MySQL. To replicate your data, click New and select Replication. Select Salesforce as source and MySQL as target. Select the objects you want to replicate. Let's replicate Salesforce accounts and contacts. Skyvia can replicate both standard objects, like accounts, contacts, leads, opportunities, attachments, and custom objects. You may change the replication options. Enable incremental updates to include only changes applied to data since the last replication run. Select the Update Schema checkbox to apply data structure changes made in the cloud app to the database schema in target. Specify whether to create or drop tables. Note that when the incremental updates are enabled, tables will be created only during the first replication run. Finally, you can configure target table naming settings. You also may configure replication for each object in more details. Exclude certain fields from replication or anonymize textual or binary fields with hashing. Configure filters for data to replicate and select the mode to use for the object. Skyvia supports the following modes: standard, which is incremental; history, store all record versions; full rsync each time, or rsync only for manual replication runs. Once this is done, you can schedule your replication as you see fit. You can run it every day or on specific weekdays, more often than once per day, every few hours or even minutes, achieving near real-time integration. Let's save the replication and run it manually. After you run the replication, you can check the execution status and its results on the monitor and log tabs. Here you will see the number of successfully replicated rows and error messages in case something went wrong. In addition to replicating Salesforce data to MySQL, you can load data in the reverse direction. Sync it from MySQL back to Salesforce with the help of Skyvia import. Actually, you can use the import tool to load data between Salesforce and MySQL in any direction, but this tutorial shows only one of them. Click New and choose Import. Select MySQL as source and Salesforce as target. To define what data to load from MySQL to Salesforce, where to load it, and how to map it, create an import task by clicking Add New. You can add any number of import tasks to your integration. Let's import users' data to Salesforce leads. Here you can optionally add filters to load only records matching specified conditions. On the target definition page, select the lead object in Salesforce to load data into and one of the available operations. Insert, update, upsert, or delete. Insert adds source data to target. Update updates the values in target according to values in source. Upsert combines insert and update operations and adds new records while updating existing ones. Delete deletes the records from target. As we are interested in updating Salesforce records, we continue with the update operation. Skyvia maps fields with the same names automatically. However, you can remap any field as you see fit. There are several mapping types available, including lookup and expression mapping for data transformations. For example, here we find the corresponding lead to update by email using the target lookup mapping. Once the mapping is configured, click Save and Create. Import integrations can be scheduled and run in the same way as replication. Let's proceed to the third scenario, integrating MySQL and Salesforce via Salesforce Connect. Salesforce Connect allows linking external data to Salesforce and allows working with it in the same way as with native Salesforce objects directly and in real time without actually storing this data in Salesforce itself. It can connect to external data sources via the OData protocol. Skyvia offers no-coding API as a service solution, Skyvia Connect, that allows you to publish data from different cloud apps and databases via OData and SQL Web API endpoints. Let's create an OData endpoint for MySQL data. Creating OData endpoint in Skyvia Connect can be done with four simple steps in a convenient wizard. You only need to select the connection to publish data from, then select tables to publish. You can configure the result OData entities in more details, hide some columns from publishing, rename entities, properties and entity sets, etc. You may configure an authentication layer for your endpoint with usernames and passwords and allow access to an endpoint only for specific IP addresses. Finally, let's specify other endpoint options, whether it is read-only or read-write, default OData protocol version, and endpoint name. Save the endpoint and you will get a ready-to-use endpoint link that you can use in Salesforce Connect and other applications supporting OData. Let's copy the link and connect our endpoint to Salesforce. In Salesforce, open Setup and navigate to Integrations, External Data Sources, and then click New External Data Source. Let's name the new data source. For the data source type, select Salesforce Connect, OData 4.0, and specify other endpoint options. Skyvia supports writable endpoints, so let's select the Writable External Objects checkbox. To configure authentication for a Skyvia Connect endpoint, set identity type to named principal, authentication protocol to password authentication, and specify the endpoint username and password. Now let's save our data source and then validate and sync it to detect the published objects. Finally, sync objects to read their metadata in Salesforce. After defining external data source and external objects, you may add tabs for these objects in order to work with them via Salesforce UI. Let's create a new tab. Here you need to select the external object and set the tab style. Other settings can be left at their default values. That's all. Now you can work with your MySQL data directly in the same way as with native Salesforce objects. You may also edit the view for this object to display the fields that you need. Skyvia has a lot more to offer for Salesforce integration with MySQL and other data sources. In addition to wizard-based tools, there are advanced data pipeline designers for complex integration scenarios, like the one we show here. Thank you for watching this MySQL and Salesforce integration tutorial. If you have any additional questions, feel free to drop us a comment below and we will help you. To try Skyvia for free, use the link in the description. See you in the next videos.